So we've seen before that there are three ways to build up the chart. One is by calling the closure or predicting. The next is by shifting. And the third is by performing reductions. I'm going to have you do all three, and this is the second one, shifting. Let's say we're currently looking at chart sub I, and there's a state in there, x goes to AB dot CD from J. And this time we're going to look at the input tokens, and they're in a list, right, called just tokens. So I'm going to have the following code in our parser framework. We're going to figure out if there's a candidate next state by calling a special procedure shift, and shift gets to see the tokens, the entire input, which token we're on, also which chart state we're on, x, a, b, c, d, and j, the current state we're considering. And based on that, there may either be a possible shift or there might not be. So shift will either return none, at which point there's nothing to do, or it will return a single new parsing state that presumably involved shifting over the C if C matched up with the ith token. So then we'd add that to the chart in position I plus one, the correct place, and we'll keep track of whether there have been any changes. You should write shift.